one twice.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Pretty good one. Thank you, Open Source Music.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, this is by Otis McDonald.
Yeah.
Hype up to Otis McDonald.
You stay in our heads all week.
All week.
We hear this song.
Yeah.
It's true. Welcome to Hype Night.
Welcome to Hype Night.
I'm Dale.
I'm Mel.
Yeah.
Here we are.
Oh my gosh.
Thanks for joining us.
Man, we have another really nice and wonderful Fantastico show today.
We do. Yeah. Did you say Fantastico?
I said, yeah,
Fantastico. I love it.
I made it up, but is it probably a real word?
It's a real word, but that's okay.
I'm just feeling
I'll give you the credit for
I'm feeling it.
That's good.
That's it.
Amazing.
Yeah. Listen, this is Hype Night, and what we do is we bring on an amazing, wonderful woman who we think is just the best.
Yeah.
And we tell you all about the hype that she is and she deserves.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We celebrate her. We felt like it was an important thing to do.
Exactly. You know, and this hype, you know, hype can sound like anything. It can look like anything at all. For example, it might look something like this.
Okay.
You know, Melissa, we've been working on the show now for 4 weeks,
mm-hmm.
and I love that you are always ahead of me on the work that we need to do. and it's very flattering. I go into the Google Doc and it's done. This woman is amazing. She gets her stuff done. Thank you so much.
Thank you. That's so lovely. I was going to say a similar thing to you. So let me modify my hype. I'm going to modify my hype. I want to say that in any given day, Dale, I will hear from you on basically every platform, and I love it. You will contact me on Facebook, Messenger, you will contact me by text, you will contact me on Google Docs, you will also contact me on my email, and I love it. And you also comment on how you're doing that.
Yeah.
You're like, hey, just because I haven't gotten in touch with you on every platform yet.
I'm going to go this way.
Yeah. And I love it because it makes me feel really special.
It's like an Easter egg hunt.
I love it. So, thank you.
Well, thank
it's
you very
creative,
much.
And it's funny, and I love it.
Thank you very much. And great.
Yeah,
okay. That's hype.
That's how we hype.
That's hype.
Compliment.
That's it.
Yeah.
You know.
It's great.
Fantastic.
Thank you for joining us. If you want to share this or comment, let us know as we hype our guest.
Mm-hmm.
Jump in. Let us know what you're thinking. If you know her, if you don't know her, and you're like, holy cow, I didn't even know her, and she's so amazing. Let us know. We want to hear from you.
All of it. Yeah. Right here. So boom. I think it's time.
I think it's time.
Yeah.
So tonight, our very special guest on Hype Night is Sandra Ballini.
I get up.
Oh, shit. I just knocked you. I knocked Dale's boob. Oh, my God.
It's okay. I'll bring it back in.
Yeah. Well, guys, it's the breakdown.
We're on it with the music today.
It's going to be a very musical night. We're very excited about our open source music.
I think...
I know, you're so...
We're so tight,
we're
guys. I realize
guys, we're so tight.
It's so tight.
We have to be, like, here.
We have to be in the frame.
Oh, yeah.
Whatever.
Okay,
tightness. Tightness. We can talk about sound.
Yeah,
we
can... People are already saying things about you.
I'm like,
so...
what is there, a dog under the table, or is just your leg?
Ooh! Is that your dog under the table, or are you just happy to see
it? Oh, what?
It doesn't make any sense. Okay, Sandra Ballini, thank you for being here.
Oh my god.
Thank you so much for being here.
I took the subway, you know?
Oh my god. It was an adventure, I bet. Right?
Yeah, and then the pig, I mean, I was here at your house at Christmas.
That's right.
Was there a pig up there?
There's always been a pig. Well, there's been a pig up there for like 4 years.
Oh, okay.
For those of you who don't know,
this is Easter egg knowledge.
Yeah. There's a pig on our roof. So we're in my home studio, mine and my husband Matt, who's working the camera and often does our shopping channel reveals on the show. We have a pig on our roof.
Yeah.
Started out as a Santa pig, like a Christmas pig, and now we changed the costume. So now it's Wonder Woman.
Wonder
pig.
Woman with the rope and everything.
Yeah, with the lasso. Oh. So maybe we'll in the comments we'll put a picture up at some point.
Yeah.
So you can see our pig.
Yeah.
He's our pig.
Yeah. We call his name is Kevin Bacon. And he's a good time.
And he's kind of like famous. He's a little bit getting Toronto famous.
Yeah, he does.
Oh, yeah?
Well, he gets Christmas cards, so the girls who live across the street...
That's hilarious.
They give him Christmas cards and Halloween cards.
I know, that's
so
great.
To celebrate. It's pretty special.
Yeah. Things are really good.
They are.
Tasty.
They're very tasty.
Yeah.
He can probably hear you.
Yeah.
Sometimes we talk about it and we're like,
He's full
just
of
outside
air.
He's just outside the window.
He's like right behind here, so because there's a window back here.
Yeah.
But it's not animal torture because he's just full of air.
Yeah, it's true.
Yeah.
Lights.
Oh,
he's full of lights.
Yeah.
Lights
in it, yeah.
So listen, usually we start with the best part of your day.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll start with the best part of my day. This is a very rare thing that gets to happen to me. It happened today. I woke up, you know, I got my morning routine done, and then I was like, I have a very rare day off.
Hmm.
I'm going back to bed.
Oh, back to bed.
I don't know. It's been literally years since I've ever done that.
Yeah, back.
So it was special. It was good. Tell
what time?
Oh, 11.
Oh, isn't that nice?
Yeah. Like, I was up at 7, and then I went back at, like, 9, and then I went to
That's like
11.
A 2-hour. Oh. That's good.
Yeah, it's a proper... I could sleep all day, though.
Yeah, I know.
That's nice.
Yeah, I could do that.
Yeah.
But can you do... when's the next time you can do that?
Oh, I could do it. I could have done it again this afternoon and then gone back to bed easily. I can sleep anytime.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Anytime.
Yeah.
That's nice, though.
Yeah.
That's really nice.
Mm-hmm. That is nice.
Yeah.
Best part of
you?
My day today... honestly, it was breakfast. So my husband and I have breakfast is the most important part of our day. We always get up together. We always make a nice breakfast and we always sit and have breakfast together. No matter what, whether one of us is working early and the other one isn't, we make an effort to do that.
That's
and
so nice.
It's nice. It was really nice.
So if he's got to get up at 5, you get up at 5?
Yeah, and likewise.
What?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Then I sometimes go back to bed, but we make an effort
to
have
lunch.
Breakfast together. Can you imagine?
That's
I
how
make his lunch.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Then, no, I don't. Make
I send
lunch.
Him off. It's okay.
It was good. And he's been wanting porridge a lot lately, and I like porridge, but I get really bored of porridge.
It's spring.
So then today
spring
we made eggs for breakfast, and I was really excited.
Yeah, eggs.
It's
what is your... Is your husband a British orphan?
Yes. He actually kind of is. He's
with the porridge?
He's part British, part Irish. Yeah.
I know. I always just associate him with being Italian.
He has an Italian last name, but
yeah,
he's half Italian. Yeah.
Secret Italian.
Secret Italian. That's going to be our next Facebook Live show. Where we out people who are secretly Italian.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I know. I do it to people all the time.
I bet you do.
Like you. I know you.
I'm like, we're going to get back.
Wait a second.
Secret Italian. I know. Sandra, what was the best part of the day?
Oh, God. There's a few of them. But
I believe it.
One of them was... Oh, no. Okay. I'll just say this one because it made me laugh. Because I was on... at college and Spadina, and there was somebody on the street asking for money.
Mm-hmm.
And when I walked by, he said, "Hey, troublemaker." And I looked, because I was like, wait, I gotta hear what this guy said, and it just made me laugh. I was like, yeah, troublemaker. Right?
Yeah.
And then I had, before that was jerk chicken, and that was, oh my God.
Oh, you can't
do you know the Rasta Pasta people in Kensington Market?
Yeah.
Jamaican Italian?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Are you kidding me?
Rasta Pasta.
Secret Italian.
Secret Italian. Jamaican Italian?
I'm not kidding. That
I love
is,
it.
Facebook Live.
New segment.
Secret Italian.
It's the most positive hype night, and then we get into this really dark, weird Secret Italian spot.
Yeah.
Hey.
You know who's not a Secret Italian?
Yeah.
Is this
gal
right over
here.
I don't know. You're like, what are you? Like a queen? You're queen. To me, you're like a...
Queen Italian?
Royalty. You're Queen Italian.
Like Queen Italian.
Yeah, you're royalty. You're Italian royalty.
I know they have a palace for me in Italy.
Oh my God.
You too, though.
Me? Well, I don't know. In the south. I'm the queen of the south.
I'm underneath Rome, so that's south
I guess
too.
You are south.
Yeah.
You always strike me as a northern Italian.
Really?
Because you do the accents
a lot. Oh, quanto parla così.
Yeah. My sister still does the whole your whole bit about the women when you
the camisole.
It's perfect. It's beautiful with the camisole. Yeah.
Because I used to work. I used to live in Sudbury, and there was like a clothing store called Bottega Mia. And the Italian women, northern, it's still there. And they'll be like, "Oh, you're so beautiful. Just all you need are some earrings, a cami, shoulder pads." It was always earrings, a cami, and shoulder pads.
You can't go wrong. If you have earrings, a cami, and shoulder pads, what else do you need?
I know.
It all focuses.
And me, my mom, and sister, like, it was all shoulder pads.
Yeah.
It was very shoulder pad, heavy, driven.
Yeah.
I know. I wonder when they're going to come back.
Yeah,
I feel
like...
they're not right now.
They're not.
But it makes your waist look small.
It does.
Yeah.
But sometimes it depends. Yeah, the
shoulder pads
is a tricky. It's a tricky.
Yeah, I think I could rock it.
You could totally.
Oh yeah, you got major shoulders.
Yeah, yeah, it's gonna. Yeah.
Just go even like Grace Jones, like just go.
If you did it
like
now,
a Sigourney
everyone.
Sigourney Weaver, like blazer working girl. Yeah.
If you did it now.
Hype Sigourney Weaver.
Hype Sigourney Weaver for sure.
Yeah. I bet up.
Listen, I want to talk about how amazing you are.
Yeah, let's do it.
We have all these things that we found about you.
Okay, what?
I don't know. Like, that you, like, all these awards and stuff that you've won. Listen, you're award-winning stand-up.
Oh, wait, before we do that.
Oh, my gosh.
We haven't even, okay, award-winning made me think of our drink today.
That's amazing.
And I think we're gonna play, let's play some music.
We found music that felt made us feel like our music, like the, like our drink today.
Yeah.
Okay.
Our drink today is a single malt scotch whiskey. Old Pulteney, or how would...
Old Pulteney.
Old Pulteney.
So where she
is. I really want to know where New Pulteney is. Or how it tastes.
Why did we get the old one?
Old one, I don't know. It's 12 years old.
12 years old.
It's been provided by Woodman Spirits and Wine. They even provided the glassware, only I broke one.
What? Sorry, Woodman Spirits and Wine.
What do you mean Woodman Spirits and Wine? Like,
Woodman.
Oh, I thought it was Woodman Spirits. I'm like, that's great. Women Spirits.
And why? You get the whole package. The whole package.
You wake up in the morning and there's just booze here for us. It's like a spirit brought into us. I have to use this glass, which is fine, but
okay,
I'm
here.
Just saying. That's what I get.
Thank God they're polished.
That's what I get for dropping it. Want? I'm good, thank you. Okay. Look at this. Okay.
I just did a yoga for the kidneys.
You're so,
so ready
for this then.
Yeah, I know. My kidneys are just flushed. Should we cheer? Should we cheerio?
Yes.
Cheerio.
It's Scottish. It's Scottish. So.
Yeah, Scottish. Whatever.
So slanta? Is that how you say it? How do you say that? Or is that... That's Irish. I don't know.
Oh, yeah.
Matt? Old English orphan? What is
Schlanta.
It? Schlanta. Thank Schlanta. You.
This always makes me... When I take a sip of this, I'm like, anything is possible. Like, anything. Like
this music is possible.
This is the part
world
where...
World peace is possible.
Yeah. I was thinking of group sex, but that's
group sex is possible.
I didn't know if we could say sex on this.
We can say anything.
Okay.
We can say anything. It's Facebook Live.
I mean, I'm not that I'm into group sex. I'm just saying, when you drink this, you're like, who knows, right? Like, it's anything.
Well, didn't we, when we were in Sudbury doing Mambo Italiano?
I'll just lean back for this one when you tell me the group sex story.
Didn't some people from our cast in the show we did in Sudbury, we did Mambo Italiano?
Yes.
These people who had eyes were swingers, and they really wanted to swing with a couple of people in our cast.
Yes.
You and Phil.
Oh, that's nice.
Let's hype Phil Lutzi.
Hi, Phil Lutzi.
Hi, Phil Lutzi.
Who doesn't want to swing with Phil?
Every day.
He's a, yeah.
Come on.
He's pretty swingable.
Yeah, he's a swinger.
It makes me, it's going to make me segue to, I watched your adding up.
You're adding it up!
Adding it up today!
So good. Okay, so Sandra has a vlog cast called Adding It Up, where? You can tell them.
I don't know, I saw it on Facebook. Yeah. Where can I find it? Find it.
It's on my pages, but it's also on the 10minutepodcastnetwork.com.
Oh, okay, there you go.
So TEN,
I love it.
10.
It's kind of like gone into my psyche, because then I went to the mail, and then I saw that I had a catalog, and then I wanted to add it up. It was a Canadian Tire one.
Oh, I have it. Yes, I know you want to add it up.
Yeah. So on this vlogcast, Sandra invites someone over and they add up all of the contents of the catalog. Because you used to do this with your sister, right?
Yeah, we would add up catalogs when we were kids.
I love it.
Add up sections and then grand totals.
Of course.
So I was like, what would make a better vlog than this? So we invite a guest. I have Phil Lutzi, who's the verifier, and Patrick Akeem. Like, I think he's just an assistant. We have to give him a title, but he's like the other verifier.
It seems like he's the other verifier.
Maybe
give him a different color.
I got it.
Different visor.
But it's the funnest thing. I can't.
So
you both have to be. Come on. And
oh my God!
I would
love to.
Are you kidding?
Are you kidding? Like, season one is IKEA.
Yes.
So I think we're gonna.
Because that's kind of like a gold. That's a pretty high up there. Like, Sears is probably, like, what are the top catalogs?
Well, you mean right now?
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely IKEA,
yeah.
Sears, Canadian Tire.
Yeah. Those are the ones,
and now
right?
I'm collecting, like, vintage ones.
Oh, that'd be good. Now, if you add up a vintage one, do you then do some kind of research onto, like, what it was worth?
That we're going to do that. Like, I just bought one for, it was Eaton's Christmas 1970-something.
Yeah.
I got one 67. Oh man, the thing with that is that when all the people are adding, each person has their own catalog.
Yeah.
So it's either, like, if I get a catalog, right, I have to either copy it somehow or...
Oh, but how great would it be, though, if you did, like, a catalog where it was like, you're going to do kitchens, I'm going to do kitchens, and you're doing 1960, and you're doing 1970, I'm doing, like, 1980.
Oh, that's interesting. Through the 80s, yeah. Through the decades.
And it's like,
then
how
that's
much
a good
more?
Idea.
Yeah.
Then that way I don't have to get it'll be hard for me to get a catalog. Yeah. Aw, thanks. That's the second time.
This is the second time
I touched her breast.
She's
crazy.
She's like, it's a magnet for you.
Yeah.
That's okay.
Are you lactating again?
No, I'm not. They're done.
Oh, okay.
They're done.
Maybe with a slight suggestion, they might.
Let's
hype them up.
Hype it up. So yeah, 10. So we're going to have weekly episodes. And these guys are going to be guests, so...
Oh my god, I can't wait.
Oh my god, I really can't wait. I was like,
you
just
need to use an adding machine.
Oh,
like,
it's
I
the most exciting
the,
and the paper
thing.
And everything.
Because I love, I just like, I grew up around bankers, so I have a strange fascination with adding up numbers and like cash money, cold hard cash.
And then me and my sister wanted to be like cashiers.
Yeah.
So adding this shit up was the perfect training ground.
I love it. It's like, I want to be a cashier.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, man, it would be fun. Social.
Yeah.
When you're a kid, that's a great gig.
Yeah.
I was one of the fastest cashiers.
I believe it.
Yeah.
Now
they're all slow.
Anything.
Like, they're all, I don't know, I'm drunk.
They're like, bag your own stuff.
Yeah.
Well, now you can be your own cashier.
And I love that.
Yeah,
me too. Shoppers, this Shopper's new self. Have you seen this Shopper?
They have them at Shoppers
now? Yeah, they do now.
The strongest scanners. You just gotta float it by and picks it up. It's amazing. I was like, oh my god.
Oh my god, that's great. Because sometimes it is frustrating when you try to scan it and it won't, and then it's like, please.
Do you know
why?
Call the person.
Because the scan is up against the wall. It's not down. So if this is the machine, you pick up your thing, scan it like this, put it down.
Yeah, I know. But sometimes...
You're doing it.
You're going like this, and it's not reading it. Don't you ever experience that? Or
no,
you
no
never
but this one,
that?
No, all the time.
Oh,
but
this, Shoppers.
But I'm saying this one, I don't know, they've got new power.
Okay. Shoppers has new power.
I like Shoppers because all you have to say is like, are you sure that's the right price? And then they go, no, you're right.
Dale, you love that.
That's me. I'm like, no, I'm pretty. And like, yeah, okay.
Amazing.
Like, I don't know,
I've never tried that in
Shoppers.
I'm
hilarious.
Such a sucker. I'm a sucker.
Does this toothpaste cost this?
No. What do you want it to cost? Damn.
I don't know. I don't want it to be free. I just want it to be a little, make me feel better.
Less. I know.
That's
sales.
All.
I love sales.
I love a sale too. Yeah.
I want
I
it to be,
help
a,
it.
You know, a
yeah.
little bit like 1980s well, prices.
I know, because it's too much. The price, everything's too much.
It is.
It's
I gotta
true.
Say.
Like,
yeah,
really?
Yeah.
Who's making all this, you know, we're going to go into that, but like, you know what I mean? All these people making money?
I know.
Oh my God. Speaking of making money.
Making money!
Just talking about all these awards that make you all these monies.
Oh my God.
Right? Like, how about the fact that you were Best Stand-Up on Now Magazine
2015?
And Best Female Stand-Up for CCS 2016.
Yeah.
Did you go?
No, not 2016. Was it 16? No, I was,
That's what it says on your site, though, isn't it?
2016?
Maybe
I'm wrong.
We just copy paste.
Yeah.
That's it. We're here. That's okay.
You won in 2007 for
Hard-Headed
for
Woman.
Hard-Headed Woman. But then
don't cheat.
No.
But then anyway, so you have the award of
best, I have a couple
stand-up
awards.
You
comedian,
have
two Canadian Comedy Awards.
Yes, okay, yeah.
And best
Hard-Headed
Rolls
Woman though
Royce,
was a fantastic show.
Oh my god, Hard-Headed Woman was so good.
I saw that one in person. It was so good.
Me too. And I remember I still to this day laugh out loud thinking about when you tell this joke about when you're swimming and you go into the change room and you're like, and I emerge from the waters much like my ancestors did. And I'm like, every time I think of that, it makes me laugh.
Do people bother you to like do another show?
Yeah.
Because I think you're very powerful in your shows.
Oh, thank
you.
You
know,
yeah.
I feel like it's like, I don't know, they're like theatrical, but then it's like stand up and your message is great and you always look fantastic. And
there's
like, oh.
Great music, you always dance in them. And
you gotta
it's
dance.
Amazing. You do the splits.
Maybe. I've been heading back to
get in
the gym.
Oh my god.
Oh, and yoga.
Ooh. Get that yoga, flush that kidney out, and then have
I just
some
opened
scotch.
I just opened my pelvis tonight.
You just opened it right up?
Yeah, I was like, it was wrapped up and I took it and I opened it. I'm already wasted, guys. Whatever.
It's okay. It's good.
And you do stand up.
I know. It's like that looks. It's distracting. I was like, who are those three people?
You know what the thing is? Listen. Sometimes people, when they think it's funny, they put little laughings go by, or sometimes little hearts go by. Sometimes you can say, everybody, give us hearts, and in like 5 seconds we'll see a bunch of hearts.
It's quite nice.
It's really.
I love
the
show already. Oh, I love that you have my resume.
I printed out Sandra Badalini's resume from her new website, which you should go visit.
Yeah.
SandraBadalini.ca. No, .net. SandraBadalini.net.
Yeah. It used to be .com, and then I was late in paying it, and then they were like, no, they're like, it's $3,000 for you to take it back.
Yeah, they'll do that. They do that.
Don't let it go.
Don't let it go.
It was terrible. And then they were like,
you
have to prove. Yeah, you have to prove that you're Sandra Badalini. So I sent them my passport photo. They're like, okay, we'll give it to you for $800. I'm like, I don't have $800.
What?
No. I know.
Boo.
Opposite of hype.
Oh, balls. Yeah.
Yeah.
No. Balls, exactly. So you do stand up all over the place.
Yeah.
You're like a fucking stand up queen. You're the Queen Italia and Queen Stand Up.
Stand up.
You're a comic at Yuck Yucks. You tour around with Yuck Yucks, right?
Yeah.
So every time I see you, you're like, oh, I'm going somewhere today for Yuck Yucks. I'm going and doing stand up.
Yeah.
We live near each other, so we see each other at lunches
or coffee shops.
Although every time I'm in that neighborhood, I see you. Without fail, I will be walking on Queen Street, and I'm not usually in Leslieville or in that part of town, not that often. But every time I am, Sandra Badalini's walking across the street or getting on the street.
It's because you never go at home. You just walk around the street.
Yeah,
that's
do.
Why she's just always walking
around.
I do. Yeah. You're a woman about town.
So, listen, if you're not from Toronto, if you're watching from far away, come to Leslieville area, which is not where we are right now, but come to Leslieville area and you'll get to see Sandra.
See Sandra.
Go get
and
an American.
And Dale. Yeah, she's... Yeah,
I'm around.
Yeah, you're there. You're like auditioning. You're grabbing coffee in between.
True. I love grabbing coffee.
Writing meetings. Come on, you're writing meetings.
My favorite thing about seeing Sandra Badalini in a coffee shop or something is I see Sandra, we talk, we have a good bitch session for like 20 minutes.
Yeah.
Conspiracy theories, the whole works, and then it's like I'm really glad I saw you, and then we go about our day.
Yeah.
That's my experience.
Yeah.
We just like see each other. It's like, hey, what's going on here? Oh, what about these people? We do basically what we just did.
Yeah.
And then
we're like, we should get together.
Yeah. We should get together and have cured meats and cheese.
We really talk
about having cured meats and cheese.
I'm gonna organize it.
Oh my god,
Lazarus.
Oh my god, yes.
Okay.
Oh my god, I love it.
I think you have an eyelash on your. Look at me.
You do. You have an eyelash.
Look at me.
Did you get it?
You got it.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's good.
Hype night.
For the super high resolution.
Isn't that like I should have wished on that?
You should have, but now it's wasted and I'll never get
it. No,
anything
you
I
wish
want.
On it.
What?
Yeah, you wish on it. Wish.
Okay, let's backtrack for a second because we know you're like an amazing stand up comedian, actor, right? We're going to talk about all that.
Yeah.
I want to go back though because you got your master's in Sudbury. So you're a Sudbury gal.
Yeah.
And you got your master's. And Dale is fascinated.
I am fully fascinated.
Yeah, like in our notes, she wrote, like, what is this?
What is this? Really?
What?
Because I was like, what is, don't put down the mind, mama. I'm like, oh, this is someone's written on your Wikipedia page and like made up like that you did a master's in history and mining in Sudbury.
Yeah.
But then I get
it's
here
the truth.
And it's like, it's
and then
the
I
truth.
Had all these stories about Sudbury. But yes, tell us about your.
Okay, so
thesis.
I did my master's thesis in history at the Laurentian University, and I did it on women who worked at Inco, which is the mining company there during World War II.
I can't.
Yeah, it still
it's
is.
So good.
And you know this movie I was telling you about? Like, I want to write a movie about these women, and I'm trying to incorporate.
You should write a movie. Definitely write
and
a movie about these women.
Let's take a minute to hype the women who worked at Inco during World War II. Oh my god.
Yeah.
I haven't read your paper, so I don't know what happened to them or how they prospered or didn't.
Well, basically, like during World War II, like mining was illegal for women to work at a mine.
Okay.
Except in a domestic or clerical or technical capacity.
Sure.
Right.
And so then when the war happened, the War Measures Act allowed them to rescind certain orders, like you know, certain legislation,
right?
And then they introduced a temporary legislation to allow women to work at Inco, but only on the surface. That's why it's called Don't Go Down the Mine, Mama, because somebody in the newspaper at the time was talking about a song that was a popular song in the late 1900s called Don't Go Down the Mine, Daddy. And they were saying that if it was changed to Don't Go Down the Mine Mama, it would have a lot of people, it would be popular because no one wanted the women to go down in the mine. And in fact, the newspaper did all these like stories about how the jobs that women were doing were so like, oh, look, she's operating, it's like she's operating an ice cream machine. Or look, it's like she's operating a sewing machine. Meanwhile, she's operating like heavy machinery.
Right.
And because they didn't want the public, in no way did they want them to think that women were taking men's jobs away from them. Because the men that were out were working.
Right.
Then when the war was over, the legislation went back, and then like it was the only example where where women, like, it was illegal for them to work there, and then when the war was over, they were all let go.
Right.
Because in the munitions factories
or in the
car factories, like, they stayed on, not obviously in the same numbers, but then the women here were like, that was it.
Wow.
I mean, some women did obviously stay, but just in those secretarial. And it wasn't until the late 70s that women could go underground anyways. But they never went back in the same numbers as in World War II.
Fascinating.
Yeah.
And actually what I read today, which I found amazing, is that you're referenced a couple of times, your paper is referenced, or your thesis, in this book called From Meteorite Impact to Constellation City, A Historical Geography of Greater Sudbury.
I didn't even know it!
By Olivia W. Saarinen. So you're like cited.
I didn't even know this!
Yeah.
No.
Oh,
your paper is cited.
Can you say that again, the name of the book?
So it's called From Meteorite Impact to Constellation City, A Historical Geography of Greater Sudbury.
Oh, what?
So,
that's
right.
Great.
So you're like, your paper is like a part of the history of Sudbury.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
And I was all like, it's fake.
I know. You're like, who's this comedian who's moonlighting as a history person?
Well, and I remember, so when we were doing Mambo Italiano in Sudbury, we had a lot of adventures in Sudbury. One of which was we went to the Big Nickel, and me and Sandra and Phil Luzzi did interpretive dance in front of the Big Nickel to The Best of Air Supply.
Oh, yeah.
Remember, we played it in your car.
I still see you, like on my windshield and Phil, like, just doing crazy
shit. We were listening to it. We were at the Big Nickel, and we got so inspired, and we opened the doors, and we just danced in the, like, moonlight.
Yeah,
it was amazing.
Yeah.
And in Sudbury, there's not a lot of light pollution up there, so it was quite...
I feel like everybody sees the Nickel in the middle of the night.
It's kind of special.
Nickel.
And it's
only if you're close to it.
I guess. Yeah.
It's pretty magical.
Yeah, it's so magical.
Yeah. But then also I remember taking a tour of a mine there, and the guy who was leading the tour was talking about men who were working in the mine, and you brought something up about migrant workers who worked in the mines. And he like tried to correct you or say something like, you mean immigrant workers, and you're like, no, I mean migrant workers, and you basically knew more than the guy running the tour. And I was like, really? They should record you. There should be like a recording at that museum.
There should be.
Yeah,
you can walk and they could do this.
Yeah.
And then you could like, or the one with the buttons.
Yeah.
And then it's like, you know what Sandra Bellini has to say about the slag, the slagged heap or whatever. And it's like.
Yeah. It's not that hot. No, it is hot. They don't have the slag heap anymore.
No.
That's what I remember going. You go to Sudbury and you go in the middle of the night, and then you watch and it's like lava going over the edge.
Right, yeah.
It was so, it literally was behind where my aunt and uncle lived, and it was like magical to watch it.
I bet.
What a thing to say though, eh? It's like, it's magical to watch. Like it's mining and it's like molten earth.
I know.
And it's magic.
Yeah,
it is, because you're just seeing like, look, it just fall down.
That thing. I thought so. I was like in high school. I went on a high school. My high school went to Sudbury for their trip.
Oh, wow.
Yeah,
people
from Washington. Yeah, my high school, it's a Jane and Falstaff, went to Sudbury.
I love it.
It's not Ottawa or Sudbury.
Yeah, Sudbury. Yeah, it's that meteorite.
Science North.
Yeah, Science North. Love Science North.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And I was just there doing a play.
Right.
And so, like, it was really, you know, being there in the winter like that. I hadn't been there in the winter like that in a long time. And there was like one snowfall that was like literally up
all
to
your
my
people
middle
are
lake
on here, by the way.
Oh,
like,
really?
Tracy Beltrano's on here. Amanda Barker's on here.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Amanda
Barker.
Oh, that's
nice.
So awesome.
So.
What's Amanda doing?
I mean, she's watching.
Amanda Barker.
She's watching you right now.
Amanda, send us a message. Tell us what you want. Tell us tell us something.
The girls are out of bingo and the boys are getting stinko.
Oh, yeah. Sudbury.
Okay, can I think no more of Inko on a Sudbury Saturday.
Okay, I have a poem from the My Thesis. Do you want me to recount it?
Oh my God, yes, yes. Okay.
So this is how I end a thesis, but it was in the newspaper.
Okay.
Oh, this girl I adore isn't there anymore. She works at a mine all day. Oh my God, I thought I knew it! Wait a minute. Oh, this girl I adore isn't there anymore. I don't know.
It's
it.
Okay. We're gonna. You're gonna send it to us. I can't believe it. We're gonna post it.
We're gonna post your. We should post the whole paper.
I always knew this last.
Yeah, we should post it.
I have. Yeah, it's on. I don't know if it's. Yeah.
It might still be online.
It's just, it's being cited. It's
cited on a book on like ebooks or something.
Yeah.
The other thing I want to say about one last thing about Sudbury, because all my memories of Sudbury are tied up in Battellini, which I think is appropriate.
Yeah.
When we went to fundraise for Mambo Italiano.
Oh my God. That was the most crazy.
We fundraised at this like Italian event at an Italian social club there, which I can't remember what it's called.
The Crusoe Club. It's huge.
Is
the
that where they
club.
Do porchetta bingo?
Not where they do porchetta. They do porchetta Saturday, and that's the place, by the way, to go eat your porchetta, not porchetta bingo.
Oh. Because
if you don't win, you don't get no porchetta. But if you go to Caruso, we went, and it was, like, I don't know what to say about that pig, but it was unbelievable.
Unbelievable pig.
Okay?
Yeah.
Ridiculous.
The theme of the show is, like, we're circling back to pigs.
Yeah, we're
going
to.
That's okay.
So we were at this fundraiser, and it so happened that night that they were doing, like, the Miss Caruso pageant. So these young girls were competing to win Miss Caruso. And so everybody loves Sandra and Sudbury. She grew up there, and everyone knows how funny she is. So they were like, Sandra, you should do something in the show. You should do something. So Sandra's like, okay, Melissa, let's do something together. So we did, a sketch where we basically made fun of the Miss Caruso pageant, where we competed to be Miss Caruso, and we got this young kid who was like an up and coming actor who was like a 12-year-old to be the host. We wrote him a script.
Was it Alessandro Costantini? Yeah, Alessandro.
Maybe he's watching.
Anyway, it was one of the highlights of my career, was doing that
who
show.
Won?
I won, and I got a colander, like a spaghetti colander to wear, and I sang Greatest American Hero.
Right.
We did competing dance routines, competing duets. So we sang duets. It was the best. It was ridiculous.
Like, we really did make fun of what was going on.
And they loved it.
Yeah.
Which was, you know.
That's good.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
It's great.
It was fun. It was like, we were making fun of it in a, like, a mean way.
Listen, I don't have any Sudbury stories. I don't have Sudbury.
But you have stories with Battellini.
Oh, I have Battellini stories. Yeah. Sure, yeah. Of course. We did Tony and Tina's together.
Yeah.
Tony and Tina.
Which I can't believe you didn't do.
I auditioned for it and I didn't get cast.
But I did. Well, I kind of did.
Guys,
I wasn't understudying.
Nothing really ever makes sense.
It doesn't
to
make
this
sense.
Girl. But you're great. You're a great improviser.
You
that's right.
Well, thank
cast.
You very much. I always there's these weird little Italian threads that run through my very waspy family, because my family grew up in my parents' family grew up in a really Italian neighborhood, so they took on like all these traditions, like doing sauce and wearing like the horns.
So
and
would
stuff
you
like
call
that.
Yourself a secret Italian?
Yes.
A little bit. My mother's lasagna is like outstanding, but it's because, you know, she was taught by a Bertola. Like, it's like these are the names, like all these names.
I love that.
Yeah. So
secret Italian.
Yeah.
It makes total sense that you were in that show.
Yeah, and even like my mother would say that she would go to like her friend's house and she'd be like permesso. Like, to go into like
permesso.
Yeah, so.
Did I say permesso when I came in tonight, or did I say pronto?
I think you said pronto.
That was not. That's what you do when you answer the phone.
Pronto?
But when I walked in her house, I said pronto. And then I was like, no, permesso. Because
permesso is like permission
to come into your house. I'm
permission.
Already here.
I'm here. I'm walking in. But do I have permission to walk in?
Yeah,
because
I'm
this
already here.
This is the like crux of being Italian, is that act right there.
Yeah.
Can I while I'm doing it?
It's all, yeah, it's so
and there's
true.
A weird, like, also, I will say, there's an uptight waspiness quality to my family, but there's also, like, a bruta figura kind of thing, too, where it's like, there are ways that you need to be and you need to present and you need to
it's
have
okay.
Your...
My family has an uptight waspiness, too. Like,
so,
right?
So
it's
is
like,
my family.
It's like Italian, I know, it's like, it's this uptightness.
Yeah.
Italians are uptight.
They're uptight.
Yeah.
They want you to pretend that they're all like,
oh, yeah.
You know,
all
dolce far niente, rilasciate. They're not.
No, they're fucking, it's too tight.
It's too tight.
It's too much worry. Yeah. Like, they worry about everything, right?
Yeah. Oh,
worry.
And then they say, well, if they're like, Yeah, but if you don't worry, then how? Then that means you don't care if you don't worry. I'm like, that's insane. Like, you're actually putting on negative energy. They don't see it.
No.
It's the Roman Catholic Church, RCC.
RCC all the way.
You're supposed to feel it.
RCC.
Well, yeah. I did Tony and Tina's for 2 years with you.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That's right. That's I know. All.
But I never, once I played your sister.
Did you?
Once, yeah. I played your sister once.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
So there's that, you know.
Yeah.
But that's it. That's about it for Tony and Tina's wedding.
But still, okay. 2 years, that's pretty crazy.
That's all right. How many years did you do it?
2 years.
2 years, there you go.
Yeah.
Okay. So we overlapped, though. We weren't there
the
whole time
not
together.
The whole time.
Yeah. But listen, that's where I first met you, and then I got to see you do shows with Tim Sims.
Oh, yeah, Tim Sims.
Good.
I love that space.
Such a good
R.I.P.
space.
R.I.P. Tim Sims.
I know.
R.I.P.
Tim Sims.
You know what was fabulous about the Tim Sims? It was wide.
Yes, perfect.
And it was shallow.
Yeah.
Like, it was only 5 rows deep, but then it was like 50 rows, like 50 seats across.
Could you, how many people fit in there? There was no,
oh,
you could fit.
It was like 140 or something.
But that's amazing.
I know, it
yeah.
was a perfect
it was,
room.
Oh, it was the best. I did 3 of my solo shows
I
there.
I know.
Yeah, I remember.
Yeah,
yeah.
I did.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I also saw you once in a show called The Sorpanos.
Oh, it was the worst.
It was
the
a really
worst.
Bad show, but you were so funny in it.
I was Mrs. Sorpano.
No, but you played a cop. Do you remember?
Oh, yeah! Didn't I play the mother, too?
You played the mother, but you played a cop. And you were so funny. You just walked in.
This is the beauty of Sandra Battaglini. If you haven't seen her perform yet, you have to see her perform. Because she will do something without saying a word, and you will lose your mind laughing. You
like,
walked on stage in a, like, amazing cop uniform, and you turned a chair around, and you sat on it, and you just stared at a person, and I lost my mind.
Really?
It was so funny. It's like, you were also in a video that we made called Man of Steel Song, which was making fun
of
we basically recreated the Superman song by the Crash Test Dummies, and you don't say anything in that video. You just make faces. You play Robin.
Yeah.
Robin, Batman and Robin. And if you watch this video, it's just your face. You are so funny.
You're
oh,
so funny.
It's inherently funny.
There's something. Yeah, here's
you,
something.
Oh,
I
you
think,
to you guys.
Oh,
come on.
I mean,
we're all like guys. We're
you.
All funny
yeah,
ladies.
Yeah.
Thank
you,
I'm like
I'm almost done my drink. So
I know me
need
too.
Some more drink.
So
okay.
Here's something I really really enjoy about the way that you perform. I don't want to put you in your head about it. But the thing that I think is amazing is that when you watch Sandra perform stand up or whatever, it's as if you have something in you that's like pulling you to the audience.
Yes.
Really?
Like you can feel that like you want to reach them. You want them to hear you and to understand you, and it's amazing. It's like
it's
from here, and it's a special thing because some people stand up there and they go, I don't give a damn or whatever, but that's not you. That's not you. You are looking for those connections with the audience, and that's special.
Yeah.
You know, I think yeah, the audience is always like when comics might, you know, lament that audience are heckling, which hecklers are shitty if they're obviously like
yes,
a heckler
sure.
is somebody who's pretty shitty. But like without they're the ones that give us gifts. Like I literally sometimes before I'm, you know, going to do shows, I'm like, I don't have anything. And I just like pray and like whatever, like if I could just riff the whole time, and that's
mm-hmm.
what happens sometimes, especially when you have those moments, those times where you don't have new material, or like, you know, obviously I've done a lot of jokes, and but there's times where you're just like, I don't want to do that set no more. Like I don't want to do those
right,
jokes
sure.
or like whatever it is, and you just want to like you want new material but you don't have anything at the moment, and you play around and
You find it. It's brilliant. It's great.
Yeah, and that comes from, I mean, like, obviously you're improv, but also you've done so much clown, and Buffon,
mm-hmm.
which, like, has really, like, I remember seeing stuff that you've, I've seen stuff that you've done at the Circus Festival, at Lunacy Cabaret. It's always so outside the box, and it's always pushing against what you're doing, the form that you're doing, which I love.
Which special show did you direct?
I directed 9/11
yes.
musical.
Oh, that is the
yeah.
That we were just looking at that poster. Like,
oh, it's a good poster.
You that show was amazing.
Was
you directed
fun to
this
work
one. Hype in Melissa. Hype in
Melissa.
Guys.
I like it.
Oh, we did a musical about 9/11.
They did. They wrote a musical about 9/11. And they asked me to direct it, and it was so much fun to direct.
And I was in it, and Phil Luzzi, and Precious
Chong, and
Christopher Sachin. Let's
Chris
hype all those people!
And Scott Christian was the,
yes,
was the
musical
director. Hype
yeah.
Scott Christian.
Oh,
jeez.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was, that was a blast.
It was a blaster.
I feel like kind of we need to do like a bam-ba-da-bam.
Yeah.
You want to do a bam bada bam?
Okay. I don't know why I'm saying bam bada bam.
No, bam bada bam.
I'm gonna do this music for the bam bada bam today.
Even though we kind of jumped on.
I love this music.
Can I? I love this. I want this every time. I think this music. Listen.
I want to see what. Oh, Mad Companion.
This music to me sounds like the Electric Light Parade at Disney on the water, not the one that's on the street, on the water, where it's like an eating, like a dinosaur, and octopus. It's so good. Right?
This is like children happy watching.
Yeah, exactly.
They're innocent. This is innocence.
This is innocence. It's called JJ.
JJ. Hard-headed woman, Canadian Comedy Award, Small Battalion of Soldiers, also Canadian Comedy Award nomination for that.
Yeah.
You've toured with Yuck Yucks, Absolute, Coast, Toronto's Most Alternative Comedy Nights, Family Slides, and Sound the Sandy Show with Galuzzi.
Galuzzi.
We have a Family Slides coming up at the Drake on June the 6th, and it's wedding edition.
Yes!
Tuesday night.
Guys, Family Slides is such a fantastic show.
So great.
It's like peep comics bring old pictures, and they like tell jokes and riff on the old pictures.
Yeah.
So good.
Great.
Yeah,
so that's great. Check it out at the Drake.
Yeah, at the Drake. Yep.
You've been.
This is so fun.
You've been on Odd Squad, Saving Hope, The Amazing Gal Pyle.
Yeah.
The show. Such a great show.
Oh, yeah, I know.
It's so weird and great. Please go watch it. Everybody go watch it.
Are they making more of it?
I hope so.
I hope so.
It's too funny.
It's so weird. But it's so, it's like, they do it with such, like, conviction.
I know.
They really do.
Yeah.
It's great. Check it out.
Yeah.
Amazing Gal Pyle. Ice Girls, which sounds amazing. Human Town. You were in Map to the Stars.
Yes.
Is that where you played, like, a Hispanic maid?
Yeah. People, I think it was just on somewhere, so people are like, oh my god, I was watching this movie and there you were, and I'm like, yeah, it was like, and it was with Julianne Moore. And then people were like, how was she? But I didn't even act with her. I acted with her with her stand-in. I met her, but I, you know, and anyways, it was she's a lovely person.
What did you do on Odd Squad? What was your character on Odd Squad?
Deadpan waitress. Where I literally served rock soup. So I served soup with a rock in it.
That's so good.
And they were like, and you were like, Odd Squad, what am I supposed to do about this rock soup, right? Is that what you had to do? Like, I don't know.
What was it? What's going on? No, they ordered something and I was like, here's your soup. You know what, buddy? I'm like,
amazing.
Anyways, also, they ate rocks.
You have a show, you also did it probably for a show called Knitterati.
Knitterati.
Which I love. Was so funny.
Yeah, it's
you and Faluzzi and a bunch of great people are in that.
Yeah, a bunch of great people.
Candice
Gregoris, Julie Bott.
Love it, Julie Bott. Oh my god, so much hype.
Yeah.
You were in Running Mates, Hank and Mike.
Oh yeah, that's
so
right.
So many great things.
Yeah.
You were in, and then you just said you were in Piazza di San Domenico, which was just, recently you did Moose on the Loose,
Moose on the Loose
in Sudbury.
Hype, Moose on the Loose.
Yeah.
You just did so much. And then you had another solo show, Classy Lady.
Yeah.
Which was also...
I saw Classy Lady.
It won. Yeah.
At the alumni.
Yeah.
There's awesome. Just so much.
I mean, I don't want to put pressure on you, but you should do another one.
You know what? My sister's been saying,
people
want you to do it. Like, I just want to produce... I want someone to produce it. Or...
Someone produce it. Somebody out there watching this... Or someone watching this who knows someone.
Yeah.
Produce the show.
Right?
That's
they win Canadian Comedy Awards. They make everybody laugh. They bring joy into the world. What are you waiting for?
Man.
What are you waiting for?
This old Putney.
Putney.
I'm great.
All right. Dale, so people have been really engaged there on
listen.
Yeah,
go on. Do
we need to read some of these?
Yes.
So let's see what's going on.
I'm
going
to give you some music. I gotta go so far. I literally have so much that it's like, I can't actually go back. Oh, Audrey Dwyer does the same thing that I do at Shoppers, by the way.
Oh, nice, Audrey Dwyer.
Okay. Yeah, that's good.
Small Battalion of Soldiers. Are you Leslieville or the beach?
Leslieville.
Okay, that was a question.
You're the beach, you're Leslieville.
She's the beach.
They meet in the middle.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a lot of people watching.
That's great.
People want you to write the screenplay.
Write the screenplay.
And I feel like you're the person to do it. So
you should
I know.
Really
do it. A lot of people just meeting each other in the group right now.
That's
That's hilarious.
You're bringing people together.
Yeah, you are.
Madalini, bringing people together.
Yeah, when are you doing stand-up next? I know you said the pictures.
Tomorrow night at the Quarter Comedy Club, Toronto's newest comedy venue.
There you go.
At Queen and John. Saturday night in Thornhill, but that's a private gig.
Ooh.
Private.
Is it a bat mitzvah or a bar mitzvah?
I don't even know. I don't know. I have to look at the gig sheet.
And then secret gig, secret Italian.
Yeah.
And a question about how the stand-in that you had to act with, how was she?
She was really nice. I was confused because when I looked at her, I'm like, wow, Julianna Moore looks different. And then, but the best was David Cronenberg. Like, after I did my scene, he kissed me on both sides of my cheek.
Whoa.
It was so sweet. Like, that was a movie, okay? That was like being on a real set. That's what it felt like.
Yeah.
Nice.
You know?
Not a commercial.
No.
Not a day player on something.
But also, they are such a great machine. And, like, you know, it just was like everything was proper.
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
Not like... You're changing in a ditch. You know, those movies?
Like all the other movies.
Yeah.
What do you mean you don't think this setup?
Yeah.
Doesn't feel
yeah, what do you
like for
it's
you?
Okay, you can show your tits in front of all these people.
Amazing.
Yeah, so listen, I'm having trouble for
what does Timpano say? What's Marco Timpano say?
I mean, Marco Timpano's all over this.
He has a lot to say, Marco Timpano.
Yeah.
Oh, he wants you to do a consumers distributing catalog.
Oh, yes.
Consumers distributing.
And Marco, you have to find me the Arbonne, the Arbonne catalog.
Oh my god.
You have to do it.
Oh my god.
Marco?
Can we
three?
Do Arbonne?
Can you get four of them? Like, if you can get four, but if you can get one, either way.
Yeah. And a lot of people, listen, there's going to be a big old oven, and you got to go and read back on it.
Go read the comments back.
Great.
Yeah.
I feel like if I click it again, it might come up.
That's so great.
Yeah. That's fun, right?
This is so great.
Yeah.
This is the funnest.
Yeah.
This is the funnest.
And, you know, we had such a good time. This has been our longest one.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I don't even feel like it's over.
I know. It's been the longest one.
So listen, there is a segment that we finish up with. It's called New Favorite Thing.
Yeah.
Okay.
New Favorite Thing. Here's my new favorite thing I'm going to start today.
Oh, I know exactly what mine is.
I have a bit of I have an undercut in my hair. And I thought to myself, you know what? I can go anywhere for an undercut. I don't need to go to the fancy salon for it. So I went into like a really, really, really old school barbershop. It just had like three time in it. And they looked at me like I was crazy. But I was like, and he was like, we don't do women's hair. And I'm like, I think that you have more experience with clippers than anybody. Just do my undercut. That's all I want.
Oh,
and
I
just
love
want
it.
Like the barbershop edition. And it was awesome. It was great. And everybody, and it was the kind of thing where like there's people, the men are sitting around and they're like bitching about what's on the TV and stuff like
obviously.
That. It was awesome.
Obviously.
It was awesome. Go into their spaces. It's so fun.
Oh, that's so great.
Yeah, that's my new favorite thing.
Okay.
I love it.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead, you listen.
Okay, my new favorite thing. I don't know if anyone, you've been watching Snatch, the new Crave TV show.
I haven't watched it yet.
And the actor Luke Pasqualino, do you want to see? Do you know who that is?
No, but he's not secret Italian.
No, not secret Italian. I think his mother's from Naples. Anyways, this guy, Luke, hashtag Luke Pasqualino. I think his real name is Luca Giuseppe Pasqualino. Can we hashtag? Like, anyways,
we're going to look him up.
You will love Snatch because there's Italian, like, it's about, you know the movie, right?
Yeah, I remember the movie, vaguely. Yeah.
Movies are all vague to me.
Yeah.
Rupert Grint?
Yes,
So from
that's from
Harry
Potter.
Watson.
Yes, he's one of the stars.
Love
it's such a great show.
Love it.
But Luke Pasqualino, I can't handle it.
Ronald Weasley, right? That's Ronald Weasley. Am I right? Matt, am I right that's Ronald Weasley?
He's not listening.
Paying attention.
He's on a 10-second. So he doesn't know we're talking about him until
right.
a few seconds
anyway,
later.
Look, he's so into his scotch, too. He's getting wasted. Yeah, thank you. He just gave me amazing. Okay, so that segues
Our studio executive is not.
He's
listening to the show.
It's the Vatra Bug of the Whiskey. My godmother's mother, this old woman, Italian woman who barely spoke English, used to watch Arsenio Hall in the 90s.
Oh my god.
And so she would watch it and she would joke about how he had whiskey. She would be like, the bottle of the whiskey, Arsenio. Like she would talk back to the screen.
So
it always comes back to me. Anyway, my new favorite thing is not only new, it's like a rediscovery of a thing. Yesterday I had to drive to Hamilton to do like a corporate role-playing kind of gig.
Right.
And so I was looking at my podcasts and there were all these new episodes from this podcast I used to listen to, and I forgot about, which is the Elizabeth Gilbert podcast called Magic Lessons. So I don't know if you read Elizabeth Gilbert's book, Big Magic. Elizabeth Gilbert wrote Eat, Pray, Love.
Oh, yes. Yeah. No, I've heard of this book. I have not read it.
Yeah, so it's a pretty great book about creativity, and the podcast is amazing because it's about, like, people write in essays about, like, where they're stuck in their creativity or where they're stuck in their life, and she talks to them, and then she brings on an expert. And so the podcast I listened to yesterday was about this woman who was, like, late in her life finding her voice as a novelist. And then she talked to Neil Gaiman, who I love, who's, like, a writer of graphic novels and novels and screenplays. And it was just so inspiring. It was, like, driving back from Hamilton, and I was on the highway, and I was like, yes, magic, creativity. Yes, this is wonderful. So if you're into podcasts, that's my, like, old new favorite thing.
That's great. That's fantastic. Well, listen,
We're done.
Yeah. I mean, normally at this point, we would say who's coming up next week.
Mm-hmm.
But we're going on a little bit of a little hiatus for a couple weeks. I think we're going to be back on the 10th, right?
May 10th. Jesus dies this weekend.
Jesus dies, and then he rises, and it's a lot for
and
us
then we have to leave the audience. It's like, we die and rise.
It's gonna take,
we rise again.
It's going to take 3 weeks. To
you know that one?
Yes, I do know that.
Or this is my favorite.
Were you
there when they crucified my Lord?
Yeah. I remember seeing Sandra do a stand-up set where she started singing that.
I want to
bring
it back.
And most of the audience was like, what's
that
happening? And I was like, yes!
Yeah, you know what, though? It's amazing. I'm not Catholic, but when I'm near Catholics, and then you guys have this, like, this little pocket of all these lyrics and all
it's
these
insane.
Songs back here that they come back.
But
like
this song is literally like, were you there when they crucified my Lord? Then they ask that another three times.
Were you there when they
nailed
him
to
a tree?
Were you
there
when
they
laid
him
in
the
tomb?
Were you
there
when the stone was rolled away?
Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble. I have to go with you. Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
Wow, this is the most blasphemous episode
I don't
we've
know.
Had.
I have, like, never heard this song.
It's insane.
You know,
it's
a spiritual. It's actually a spiritual. It's not a... It wasn't written
but they're just
Catholic.
Asking questions. They're like,
look,
were you there?
It made my Facebook stop working. It just made it stop working. It just stopped.
What did?
This you're singing
amazing.
This song.
Sorry,
it's so
everybody.
Blasphemous. It's like, it can't do it.
Check out Sandra Battaglini at sandrabattaglini.net.
That's right.
Go see Family Slides at the Drake.
Yes.
On the 6th of June.
Such a great show.
And hopefully we'll see you again
we're
gonna
see you
May 10th. When we have a whole new set of gals that
we're
going to
celebrate.
We're
going to line up all of our next guests because we love Hype Night and we love that you watch it. So thank you very
much.
Thank
you,
thank
you.
Thanks for having
us. Thank you, Sandra Battaglini.
Yeah. Love these gals.